Hi, yeah, in today's video, I will show you how to create the Kali Linux USB installers or USB Lite. So first step, obviously, you're gonna need the Kali Linux image, which can be downloaded from the official website. And secondly, you can create a USB using the dd command. The dd command is available on Linux as well as Mac OS. However, I will show you the second way to do it using Balena Etcher, which it's a cross-platform applications, would mean that it will work on either Linux, Mac OS, or Windows. One of the thing about using the dd command, once the command executed, there are no going back. You can potentially accidentally override the device, the stored device that you do not intend it to do. So for the beginner, I'll say you should stick with the Etcher. It's easier. It's a graphical user interface. It's better than dd command. However, it's still a good idea that you learn how to know how to use the dd command on the command line interface. And with that, let's get started. So you're gonna download the either the Kali Linux installer. If you wish to create a USB installer, or you download the Kali Linux Lite for the USB Lite. Alright, and I already downloaded the boot image. So the next step, we're gonna open up terminal, and first we let's do the apt-get command. apt-get -l to list all the disks available that currently connected to our system. So here it is. And after that, you're gonna plug in the USB device, and we're gonna run the same command again. If you click on the up arrow key, you're gonna repeat the last command and enter. All right, so the new one we just inserted, that the USB drive, that my 128 GB USB drive. So that's the one we're gonna run the dd command on to create a USB Kali Linux USB Lite. Alright, so before we do that, we're gonna do the cd command or change directory, and we're gonna change the directory to where we downloaded the image, Kali Linux image file. Enter. Alright, and that's the image. So we're gonna use the dd command. So it's gonna be dd, and it's gonna be if equal kali.linux.2020.4. This is where you can put either the installer or the live. If you want to create a USB installer, then obviously you're gonna go with the first one. If not, you're gonna go with the second one. So for the purpose of this tutorial, I will create a USB Lite Kali Linux. So we got dash Lite dash AMD64.ISO, and gonna be off equal let slash dev, and that's gonna be the SDA. Be careful using this command, make sure that you have the correct one. Like I said before, you can override unintentionally the storage device that you do not want to override. So be careful, because when you execute this command, then really no going back. Echo 4M, the block size gonna be 4M, and So if you execute this command like this, there would be no indication until it finished. Then it would show in the terminal records in and records out. But other than that, you will not see anything. So be patient. If your USB have a light indicator, it will be flashing. Or you can add it in another option, status equal routers, and it will show the routers of the dd command. And once you do that, hit enter. Oh, I forgot. So to run the dd command, you will need to run it using the sudo command. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and copy the dd command again. And then we're gonna paste the command. And all right. It's gonna take a while for it to create a image, copying the image to the USB. So if you using the dd command on Mac OS, it's pretty similar. The only difference is that instead of using the fdisk to list all the disks, you can on Mac OS you're gonna use a disk util and list. And the dd command on Mac OS, it should be the same. It's just the device name. It should be different. All right. It showed the record ins, record out, would mean that the dd command already executed, and the data have been writing to your USB drive. And that's how you create a USB Kali Linux USB Lite or USB installer using the dd command. The next step, I'm gonna show you how to create it with Balena Etcher, which is a graphical user interface. It's easier and probably user friendly for the beginner. All right, with that, we're gonna head it to Balena Etcher to download the or to install this on our system. So as you see, Balena Etcher actually available on it multiple platforms. It's available on Windows, Mac OS, as well as Linux, cross platform. So when you're looking for Debian package, and it depends on what OS you're using. For Windows and Mac OS, you seem like just download it. But if you're using Linux, I like to use the Debian package. But that's just my personal reference. You can use the app image. It's really up to you. All right, and we're gonna add the Etcher. I'm gonna copy it, and I still have the command terminal open. So I'm gonna do a CD to go back to directory. All right, and enter. Okay. And next one, we're gonna trust the bintray.com. We're gonna add the key. So I'm gonna copy that one. Going back to terminal. Gonna paste the command and enter. All right, it added. So next step, we're gonna do apt-get update. All right, and next one, we're gonna install the Etcher. And And it's gonna be yes. Alright, so now that we have Etcher installed on our Kali Linux, next step is we're gonna open up that applications. Alright, super easy. It's the same across platform, same GUI, graphical user interface. So we're gonna select the FlashRom file, and then once again, if you create a line USB installer, you're gonna select the first one, or you're gonna select the installer to create a USB installer. Alright, we're gonna go with the first one for this tutorial. Open, and then select the target. And I'm gonna select the Samsung USB tray again. And select that one, and we're gonna flash it and continue. And there we go, it's flashing. One of the benefits using Etcher, you can see the status of it flashing the data to your USB drive if your USB doesn't have the data lie indicator. So after it's finished writing the data, it's gonna validating the data. And all right, it completed. So now that you have a Kali Linux USB installer or USB Live, thank you for watching. If you think the tutorial is helpful, don't forget to give me a thumbs up, subscribe and like, and possibly share my video. Again, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Bye bye.